You made reference to the Bay of Pigs. Indeed, it was a great humiliation for Kennedy, and for many observers, it was an almost emasculating experience. I mean, he was in office for 3 months, and he had this remarkable debacle on his hands that was the signature failure of his presidency. However, he had a remarkable opportunity to redeem himself in October of 1962 in his management of the missile crisis. And it was during that period where Bundy advised the president to take three different positions in 24 hours. He said, in essence, that he should go forward with surgical airstrike. And then he said in another meeting, perhaps the United States should do nothing in response to the missiles. Then he supported the quarantine and the diplomatic track that we, in fact, pursued. And then at the last minute, he reversed himself and joined with a coalition that was trying to reverse the president's predilection for the quarantine and go back to the airstrikes. And Kennedy was frustrated with Bundy's performance here, held his ground, obviously, as we know how the Cuban Missile Crisis ended, with the successful resolution of that and a negotiating track. What we also know in retrospect is that if Kennedy had not been so resolute in eschewing the military option, because he didn't think any kind of surgical strike was possible, he said, unless you can tell me I'll get every single one of those missiles, I don't know if this is going to work. What we now know in hindsight, because of some of the groundbreaking research that has been done on this period, is that at that time, there were 164 operational nuclear warheads on the island of Cuba, and that those Russian and Cuban officers there, the Russians supervising the Cubans, had authority to use them, and that if there had been an airstrike, there would have almost necessarily been a response with tactical nuclear weapons. And one could imagine in the blink of an eye how this could have escalated to apocalyptic proportions.